first production at Berkeley Rep 7 or 8 years ago, I was approached by Berkeley Rep to commission to write a play. The ground floor process was really great. We workshopped it. I made a lot of changes to it. We were in the right environment to really nurture this piece. I started to write about my growing up in Oakland and some of the issues that I faced as a young person here. And believe it or not, that evolved into this historical play. What's really unique about Oakland and why I love Oakland so much is Oakland has a very rich cultural tradition. What happens often is the stories that are put on Oakland are about violence and about poverty. And I think those things are real, but I think compared to what Oakland has offered this country and the world, it's much richer. And what I would offer young people is to look at the full story. A large portion of my family is from New Orleans. And so I started to do a lot of research about it. A lot of people, when you buy a home in the Bay Area, those people wonder, why is there a palm tree in our backyard? And that comes from people from Louisiana, Los Angeles as well. A lot of people in Los Angeles, their ancestors have migrated from New Orleans, from Louisiana, and that's why you see a lot of palm trees. It's just a rich, fascinating culture. And I came across this period of 1830s and this social class called the Placés, which are African-American women who were in concubine relationships with white men. I thought this would be a great play because a lot of people don't know about this history. A lot of people do not know that African-American women were millionaires. I'm so fascinated with stories that are buried in the ground and somehow got left. And I'm really interested in exposing, you know, digging these stories up and saying, look what I found. This really did happen. What can we take from that? Because there's a reason why a story is buried and another story is told on top of that story. You know, there's always a reason about that. And who does that fake or new story empower, and who does it oppress? I think what's really powerful about the play and about this time period is there's different notions of freedom. So for some of the women, having money is freedom. That's the freest as you're gonna be. And then for one or two characters in the play, it's an internal freedom that you can actually free yourself through your own means of understanding who you are. And then there's the freedom of actually making a place for yourself in society that may not be financial. And so I think giving a person their history or giving a person a particular history both shows us how far we've gone as people in this world. It also shows us that some of the things we struggle with still are happening today. And we also, inspires us and motivates us to make change, positive change in our lives. Come and see it.